Self-storage is big business and can help us create space in our overcrowded homes.
Look at all this!
I can't believe it!
But some have taken their storage hoarding too far.
I'm throwing that away. Don't worry, I've got it.
Give it to me, please.
No.
Clinging onto things they never see or use.
This is my life in a box, isn't it?
And it's costing them a fortune.
I've spent £80,000 or thereabouts on storage.
I'm Maggie McKenzie, and I'm an expert in clearing junk and people's excess baggage.
You actually paid money for this.
It's nice when it's lit up.
I'll be asking hoarders to open the doors of their unit. Empty out their stash.
I wish I was like that.
And choose to either keep it.
I'm feeling a little emotional.
Skip it or sell it. Our antiques expert will then pull out any hidden gems.
You've got a minimum of £4,000 to £5,000 in the silver.
Yes, that's what I like to see, ma'am.
To take to auction and make some hard cash. In today's show, we meet two very different storage hoarders.
Don't worry, I've got it.
Give it to me, please.
No.
Give it to me, please.
One can't let go.
That's someone's teeth.
While the other can't move on.
There's a lot of memories in two boxes.
It's time for these forgotten treasures to pull their weight or end up on the scrap heap. Welcome to Storage Hoarders. Britain is bursting at the seams with storage units as we keep more of our unwanted items under lock and key. I'm in Guildford to help two hoarders confront their clutter, lighten their load, and create some cash when they decide to keep it, skip it, or sell it. Our first hoarder in need is train collector Anthony and his daughter Philippa. At this unit, he's clocked up over £62,000 housing his collections of trains and memorabilia for the past 18 years in six containers. So, does he think he's gone too far?
They all think I'm mad. Anthony, why are you spending all that money? Do something about it. Get rid of it all. And my answer is yes. My answer is also, no, that's my soul in store. You're trying to get me to destroy my soul.
Anthony hails from Englefield Green, Surrey, where Marilyn Monroe honeymooned with Arthur Miller. But for daughter Philippa, the honeymoon period is over for Anthony and his storage.
What I think my dad has in storage is, in my eyes, a lot of c***.
Self-confessed collectaholic Anthony admits he can't let go of things. After getting divorced and moving to a smaller house, he was stuck with the problem of where to put the masses of paraphernalia he refused to lose.
I've got a lot of train stuff, from tabletop toys to ride-on toys, a live steam locomotive, and so much.
Anthony is a classic storage hoarder. Instead of cluttering his house, he prefers to store it away any way he can, including in his garage.
God. Right. How far back does it go?
Well, just the length of a car.
We did just try and ignore it. We all ignored it, but then it became quite apparent that we shouldn't ignore it anymore. Wow, you got a lot of stuff, Dad.
Yeah, a lot of important stuff.
So, when we look in storage, is it just going to be this times 100?
Yes.
OK, I don't think I can look at this anymore. It's making me a little bit nervous.
Yes.
Well, so, let's just close the door and forget about it.
At least the sun's shining.
At 71, Anthony's grafting early morning shifts at Heathrow Airport to keep up his monthly storage bill of £289.
It would be really lovely to see him not have to work so hard. You know, he goes to work every day, and it would be lovely if he could go part-time and not have to worry about his monthly bills, one of which is a big one because storage costs a lot. But he could have spent that on himself or, you know, me.
To think that I spent that amount of money, it really makes me sick to the stomach.
Can I encourage Anthony to downsize the storage and finally tackle £62,000 worth of bills?
I'm speechless.
I am too.
Yeah. My inheritance.
I'm actually quite lost for words. I didn't know it was going to be this much. It must be on your mind a lot of the time, is it?
No. As long as I've got the money to pay for it, and so far I haven't been embarrassed, then, you know, I have been happy to continue.
Anthony, what's actually in these units?
What's in the units? Really, the contents of a house.
What isn't in the units is the question. Everything. There's a little bit of everything.
So why are you hanging on to these things?
Because they are... Some things are precious to me.
Sentimental
things. Needs.
And also, he doesn't like to throw anything away.
No, I do recycle as much as I can. I like keeping things. I am a hoarder, but, there we go. I've said it, haven't I?
Yay, progress!
No, didn't put the words into your mouth, they came
they're
out.
They're normally collectibles, which other people might say you hoard. But
we know, don't we? Yes.
This is where we agree to disagree.
Well, I think it's Team Philippa and Aggie versus Anthony. We better get cracking.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's crack the whip.
Right.
Let's move it.
Our next hoarder in denial is actress Françoise Pascal. With the help of friend Julie, she wants her storage days behind her as they've cost her £1,265 over the past 8 months. So why the need for storage?
Well, when my late partner died, I moved from Hampshire to London. And, of course, I accumulated a lot of things with him.
Françoise has now downsized her property to an apartment near Beckenham, southeast London. The management of her former larger home proved too much for Françoise after her life partner, Simon, died.
I'll never find another one like him. And we'll never find anyone like him. Ever.
Françoise found letting go of her late partner's memory incredibly difficult and decided the best thing to do was put all their belongings into storage. Today, her clutter-free one-bedroom flat hardly contains any possessions from her past life.
This is all I have from three bedrooms full of clothes before. Now I'm left with these. Not much.
Close friend Julie thinks now is the time to face the past.
I think now's a good time for her because I think it's gone over too long over the years. And it's sometimes always very hard to let go.
I think Julie wants to see me move on and, you know, get rid of whatever the past is and just, you know, get on with it. Get on with the things that I really need to get on with.
As a pin-up in the 60s and 70s, Françoise enjoyed life in the fast lane, appearing in TV shows and movies.
I had an incredible career, worked with the most wonderful actors.
But motherhood slowed down Françoise's acting career, and now she's struggling to pay her storage bills.
And at one point, things were going fantastically well, and I was able to pay the storage with no problem. But then afterwards, you know, things just got worse and worse and worse, and I just couldn't do it.
With all her past possessions and memories locked away, Françoise feels lost.
It's very, very hard. But, you know, you survive. You do survive.
I actually think Françoise really needs a break. She certainly needs a new start. She's been through an awful lot. Certainly in the last few years I've seen her, and I actually think this year is her year.
Here's to a
here's
new
to
life.
A new life.
And a holiday.
And a holiday.
Can I help Françoise shed her money worries as she takes a trip down memory lane?
So you're looking to empty your storage units?
Yeah.
And either sell or get rid of?
Yeah.
Everything?
Absolutely everything.
Good. And are you up for this?
Yes, I think so. With support of Julie, I think I will be up to it.
So why haven't you sorted this out before now?
I think it was the thought of having to go into it and look at it and remind myself and it was quite painful, very painful. So this is why I didn't go into it that much.
And how much does it cost each month?
About £159 a month.
About 100, that's quite a lot.
That's a lot of money to actually come out for somebody who's only on a pension.
Julie, do you think it's going to be easy for Françoise to let go of everything?
We spoke last week, and I actually think she's ready to part with a few things, you know. There's going to be a few things she's going to get very, well, quite emotional. But I think at the end of the day, it is the way forward. Mm-hmm. Like I told her, there's no point in hanging on with the past.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Françoise, we're going to support you. That's what we're here for. So let's go and do it now.
Okay.
Come on.
We've met our hoarders in denial. It's now time to sort the treasure from the trash. Coming up...
Oh, hello.
Françoise is reunited with the past.
I'm feeling a little emotional.
Anthony refuses to let go.
We're selling it then.
No. That's not negotiable.
And some items reveal hidden value at auction.
360, 380 there, 400.
Welcome back. We're here at Guildford's largest mobile storage facility to help two storage hoarders stop spending more than they can afford on stuff they never see. Earlier, we met former pin-up girl Françoise, who stashed her past possessions in storage after the love of her life, Simon, passed away. And serial hoarder Anthony, who has to work early morning shifts to bankroll a storage habit he's had for two decades. Later, I'll be asking our antiques expert to pick out any unwanted treasures they can take to auction to recoup some of the money they've spent.
It's the moment of truth. We're about to prize open our hoarders' units and see what the past reveals.
First up is Françoise, who over the course of 8 months has spent £1,265 to keep her memories on ice.
It's not easy, but
I'm scared.
Inside this unit are the memories of a shared life Françoise had with her late partner, Simon.
The memories of Simon, memories of buying little bits and pieces, you know, going out, being happy in the happy days.
This is the first time Françoise has been reunited with the contents of her unit in 8 months.
A long time.
I want to be there to support her as she deals with downsizing her box of memories.
Hello there.
How are you? How is it?
Yeah, okay. Oh, God, the memories.
Is it strange seeing this stuff?
Yeah. It's emotional. I still feel a pang in my stomach, you know. My heart is jumping.
So you're looking forward to getting it all out and having a look through it?
A little apprehensive, emotional, yeah.
Okay, so we're going to get some help taking all the stuff out because there's lots of big boxes and bed and heavy stuff. Mm-hmm. I don't think we girls should be doing any of that.
Absolutely
to you,
not.
No. Should
absolutely
we get the boys in?
Yes, please.
Right, okay, I'll go and get them.
I want Françoise to try and disentangle the practical from the emotional as she sorts through her stuff. It's now Anthony's turn to come face to face with his storage units.
You ready?
I think I'm psyching myself up.
This will be the first time Anthony's daughter Philippa has seen the extent of her father's hoarding habits.
I can smell the mildew.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, so these can go, these rotten old dining room chairs. You don't need those.
Certainly not.
Packed away in these units are decades worth of odds and sods that Anthony's collected through his life.
What are those buckets?
Rather than let things go, he's paid over £62,000 to keep them locked up, just in case he needs them one day.
There's a lot of stuff that I don't think's worth keeping. Can you tell there's going to be some resistance?
Anthony knows he needs to declutter, but is he ready to let go? I'm determined to pave the way.
This isn't looking good so far, is it? What is that? Is that a grass roller or what?
Well,
is it?
I think it's for spreading weed killer.
Hang on. You think?
Well, my next door neighbour gave it to me when they went back to Norway.
Have you got a use for it?
Not at the moment.
Not at the moment.
This is what I'm dealing with.
Will you ever have a use for it?
Hopefully, one day.
So, I think we need some help here, because there's an awful lot and we haven't got that much time.
I can feel I'm going to have a real challenge on my hands with Anthony. I don't think he's going to let go of even the most worthless item without a fight. In order for our hoarders to clear through their items, I want them to split their stash into three categories. Skip it for those unwanted pieces, keep it for the items they really do love, and sell it for the bits that could bring in some cash. I've also included a charity bin.
Oh, my sofa!
That's someone's teeth.
Toilet paper in there, I can't believe it.
They've got just 3 hours to get their stuff out and sort through it.
Oh, is that a TV? either. I could be Skip.
So it's time to get tough with their stuff.
This is from a BMW.
That's a BMW, yes.
Do you need to keep that?
I think, no. It's kind of a modern thing you put up on the wall.
No.
Leave it in there.
Anthony's hoard is practically taking over the whole storage area.
Can you please just put them in the charity pile?
No.
While Francoise's pile is all over the place and she's having difficulty finding anything.
Clothes again. My God, how much clothes have I got?
Oh, I don't think me, but...
Oh, yeah, it looks suitable.
Yeah? OK.
Francoise is distracted from the task in hand when a toast from the past is revealed.
There's the crystal glasses.
The glassware of happier times when Francoise and Simon would entertain.
They are glasses underneath there that I'm so frightened that they're broken. Because
are they all crystal in there?
I feel Francoise is lost in the layers of her history and it's time to bring her up to date.
How are you getting on with certain things?
It's dirty. It's dirty work.
So, do you mind if we go through this box and see if you need to just keep absolutely everything? Because unless you have room for it and you would actually use it, will use it, you know, it seems a bit... There's quite a lot of stuff there, you see. Can we go through it? Now, is this any use? I mean, it's very cute and pretty, but actually, what would you use it for?
Because I was on my own, I used to use, you know, buy sort of, you know, vegetables and boil them and then put them in there, and it's my little sieve.
Look, this is what I call a decent-sized colander.
Yes.
Why don't you get rid of the little one? You don't need two, and the bigger one is more useful. Oh, good girl, love you.
One small victory. Francoise needs to realise that she can't move forward while clinging on to the past.
I know that once the stuff is gone, you will not think about it twice.
No.
You won't.
It's a good time for me to just take, you know, sort of like say goodbye to the past here.
For selling?
Yeah, these are.
Downsizing doesn't mean erasing the past. Memories are kept in our hearts, not in the bottom of a storage crate. Meanwhile, over in Anthony's lot, even the most important meal of the day has been stored away.
Sugar puffs, 18 years old.
And it comes with a lion.
Philippa is struggling to get her head around what her dad insists on keeping.
I'm not going to sit on that chair that was made 30 years ago.
Although it does the same thing as the chair you might buy tomorrow.
No, I don't think it does do the same thing. I think there's been advancements in back chairs.
So this is what you're meant to do?
No, the other way around. With your knees.
I don't really want to keep this.
And she's starting to lose patience. I wonder if I will have better luck.
Anthony, what's the story behind this?
I think someone gave that to me as a present.
Right.
So, it, you know, obviously keep
it. We're selling it then?
No. That's not negotiable.
This is one tough hoarder. Unlike Francoise, who appears to have broken the back of sorting out the past as her cell pile is slowly coming together.
Stop.
That's it, yeah.
OK.
And there's one showbiz curiosity that's really caught my eye.
So, Francoise, tell me about this photograph here.
Oh, this is a photograph of Spike Milligan, Peter Sellers and Harry Sickham in the original Goon.
So you met both Spike and...
I know.
Harry
Sickham. Yeah, but well, I actually worked with Peter on There's a Girl in My Soup and Soft Beds and Hard Battles. Yes, I did two films with him. And Spike, I've met many, many, many years ago when I was about 16 years old. Eric Syke and Spike Milligan had a little office in London, and I was looking for a job as a receptionist. Years later, I saw Eric Sykes and I said, Eric, do you remember this little 16-year-old shy 16-year-old sitting at your receptionist? He said, oh, yeah, you're the one with a very short skirt.
I think this is a great piece of movie memorabilia, and Francoise has other autograph pieces to sell as well. I want to know if there is value in a signature. So I've called in antiques expert Gillian Anderson Price. With an eye for a collectible, she knows where to go for evaluation and is taking Francoise to Fraser's Autographs in London to meet autograph buyer Anya Poliniak.
OK, so we have got a lovely, strong signature of Spike Milligan in silver pen, and Harry Seacomb, which was black pen but has faded significantly, unfortunately. Yeah. They do look genuine to me. These ones are, you know, done with a very confident hand. And
so you have no doubt that these are genuine signatures?
They are fine.
Fantastic.
Yes.
So what kind of evaluation would you put on a piece like this?
If you were to take it to an open market and sell, it's between 70 to 100 pounds.
Have you got some other, maybe slightly more valuable signatures you could show us?
Yes, absolutely. We have a number of those. In terms of film memorabilia, we've got this wonderful photograph of Monty Python.
Oh, wow.
Signed by
every single one of them.
Every single one of them, yes.
And what's the kind of retail value on that?
We are expecting, it is in auction, we're expecting to get between £800 to £1,000 for it.
Celebrity autographs have always been big business. In fact, near the end of their careers, both Picasso and Andy Warhol could print money simply by signing napkins. Royal signatures fetched the most, with Edward IV's scroll being valued at £175,000. Fingers crossed Francoise finds a Goons fan with deep pockets when it goes to auction.
We found some valuable stuff.
Okay.
Which is that train sign.
Oh, yes. Oh, what's this?
Let's go and have
it. Oh, yes.
Train enthusiast Anthony has stored away his collection of train memorabilia for the past 18 years. However, with Philippa's persuasion, he's decided to put some pieces on his cell pile.
Holland Africa line. Do you know it's valuable?
Yes. But what the current value is, I'm not quite sure.
So, how long have you had this?
1968.
And did you buy it?
I bought it from British Railways.
Did you? Can you tell us how much you spent on it?
£148.
So, apart from the nameplates here, is there anything else in your stash that you think is particularly valuable?
Yes, probably. I have a 5-inch gauge live steam locomotive, Royal Scott class. There.
Gorgeous.
Bring it out and show you.
Wow.
Yeah. I think that's worth getting valued, don't you?
Yeah.
That's a brilliant find and hopefully will help recoup some of the £62,000 Anthony has spent on storage so far. It's time for one last push as our hoarders sort out the last of their hoard.
Throw away.
With Philippa's help, Anthony's downsized about a crate's worth of stuff onto the skip and sell pile.
That's a forklift truck.
You want to sell that, don't you?
Yes.
Yay!
But whether we can get that out...
Do you think we can get that out?
We can't, really.
However, he still insists on keeping loads of his stuff, much to my and Philippa's frustration.
I actually think this should go to charity.
Charity begins at home. I want to keep it.
What? Are you but going also, to use it?
Well, we'll have it valued, then.
No,
it's not going to be worth anything.
Why is
no,
it worth anything?
Because it's tat. So I didn't really mean to say that. Forgive me, I didn't mean to say
that. That is gold-plated.
I don't think it is.
If you told me it was tat and out of fashion...
It's tat and out of fashion.
OK.
Yes.
Well done, I'm very proud
yes.
of you.
Why did you say that a long time ago?
Well, that's one small triumph. Time's up and Francoise has emptied her two crates while Anthony has downsized one of his six crates into keep, skip or sell piles.
High five. Don't leave me hanging.
The next step is to find out if there is any value in the pieces they want to sell. Coming up, our hoarders find out the true value of their treasures.
Today, I would offer you...
And we see how Francoise's past performs under the hammer.
I want 360, 380 there, 400.
Welcome back to Storage Hoarders, where I'm helping our two hoarders in denial sort through their stuff as I ask them to keep, skip or sell.
To help recoup some of the cash our hoarders have spent on storage, I've asked antiques expert Julian Anderson Price to cast a curious eye on their sell piles in the hope of finding some hidden gems to take to auction. Julian's passion for antiques has secured her a place in the glitterati of interior design. If anyone can get Anthony on board the gravy train, it's her.
So,
We've been waiting for this moment, Gillian.
Me too, I'm excited.
Excellent. Can you tell us what you think about some of these things?
Yeah, there's lots of great stuff. These presses are fantastic, super decorative, great as paperweights, nice on a man's desk. Plus, you can have new plates made for them. So you could have your own initials, the name of your house, you know, that kind of thing. Definitely, we have to send these to auction. They're not make a huge amount of money, but they're certainly going to make, 20 to 30 pounds each.
Not bad for something that's been locked away for 18 years.
I noticed there's a big clock down here. It's missing its finial on the top. It's also missing a lot of its innards. I still think it may as well go to auction, unless you're massively attached to it, because it's a decorative old clock, and somebody's going to buy it and restore it and really enjoy it.
As well as the clock, something else grabs Gillian's attention.
Now, you're probably going to find it strange, but do you know what I really like is the china cabinet. Very ordinary, mundane, old-fashioned piece of furniture. Mm. But put it in your bedroom, fill it with shoes and handbags and other accessories.
Oh, that's
a
good idea.
You know, it's kind of glamorous and fun.
Ooh, I want to keep that for me.
Yeah.
What about the left-handed scythe? Because I find that... The fact that my dad has that is quite hilarious itself.
It's quite interesting that it is so specifically left-handed. Decorative. I mean, decorative, somebody with a big farmhouse, you know, put it over a sort of inglenook fireplace. Sure, send it to auction. Absolutely.
But what's really caught Gillian's eye is the big red machine in the corner.
Obviously, there's this fantastic forklift here. Obviously, it is completely within my realms of expertise. You know, the red colour certainly must make it more desirable than an ordinary black one. Seriously, though, there is a buyer for everything. Can't off the top of my head think who's going to buy it, but I'm sure somebody's going to.
Well, let's hope so, because among the items going to auction are... two decorative embossing stamps estimated at £20 to £30 each, a 1930s china cabinet valued at £50 to £80, a left-handed scythe estimated at £20 to £30, and a very glamorous hand-operated forklift weighing in at between £200 and £400. Although Anthony's train collection is on his sell pile, he is having second thoughts about selling it. However, he is curious about its value.
Now, the thing with railway memorabilia is I don't think the market has ever dropped for it. It's always been highly desirable and highly collectible. I would love to get some specialists to have a look at these, and maybe if you'd like to sell them is to put them into a specialist railway auction, because I think there's quite a large amount of money in them, particularly in this Holland Africa line.
Yes.
So it would be really interesting to find out exactly what you've had locked away.
I've taken Gillian's advice and sent Anthony to the Cotswolds to meet Railway Anna collector Neil Booth. He'll be able to give an accurate value on Anthony's pieces and might be tempted to give an on-the-spot offer if he likes what he sees. The question is, will Anthony be prepared to sell?
Absolutely amazing.
Yes, we've got regional totems here. The totems are the station signs, as you can see.
British Railway Memorabilia, or Railway Anna, is a remarkably buoyant market, with some station signage fetching over £40,000. Let's hope that Anthony's is in the same league.
This has been intriguing me, wondering what's in the box. I know it was very heavy when we lifted it out of the vehicle. Wow, look at that.
It's a live steam loco.
Fabulous.
5-inch gauge.
Live steam locomotives have been popular in the UK since the late 19th century. The first engine being invented by British eccentric Lillian Curley Lawrence at the age of 13 in 1895.
The livery is quite nice. It's not too polished. It doesn't look too new.
Yeah.
The actual loco itself is a very desirable class. I haven't seen one of these in that condition for quite a number of years. Value-wise, I would like to put a value. I would value it that around about £2,500 to £3,000.
Yes. Wow, that's an astonishing amount to keep hidden away. And Anthony still has another artifact of memorabilia to be valued.
What have we got here then, Anthony?
Well, this is the nameplate, which I have loved owning, and I want to make sure that it goes to a good home.
Oh, that is absolutely superb, isn't it? Have you any idea what side, which side of the loco?
No.
You haven't? No. So basically, a lot of it is, if you think about it long and hard and look at the way the flag is flying.
Yes.
Now, I could tell you that that is actually the left-hand plate.
I was going to say, from what you just said, left-hand
plate. That is the left-hand plate because the flag is flying to the right.
Yes.
And, of course, you've got the mast here.
Yes.
Obviously, the other side would have been flying the other way. Now, I believe the other side is in private hands at the moment.
Yes.
Steam locomotion rail plates like this always come in pairs. But since the scrapping of all decommissioned engines, any trace of Railway Anna fetches a handsome price.
You've got several options. We can actually sell it on a private treaty basis by offering it out to various private collectors. We can make you an offer for it here and now, if you wish. Or you've got the option of it going to auction and set a reserve on it.
Neil's so impressed with Anthony's rail plate that he's prepared to make him an offer.
Today, I would offer you, I would give you a cheque today of £18,000 for this plate.
Right.
If you wish to consider that.
I will consider it, but...
It appears Anthony's been sitting on a goldmine of Railway Anna. However, he loves his pieces so much he's decided to decline the offer and hang on to them.
I found the day really, really useful. Neil is a delightful guy, and the advice he's given me is priceless, one could say. And also, he's a world of knowledge, so I found that interesting as well.
It's slightly disappointing Anthony doesn't want to put this railway memorabilia under the hammer, but as long as he takes them home and loves them, that's all that matters. Let's see how his other items get on.
Look at this.
We're here at Chiswick Auction House to see how Anthony's stash does when it goes under the hammer. Here's hoping for some high bidding.
360, 380 there, 400.
A little birdie has told me that out of all the items that were chosen to come to auction, you've retrieved a couple of them.
I've taken them out. I've decided they are not going to be sold at this time.
It appears that Anthony wasn't quite ready to let go of all the stuff on his sell pile. However, he is prepared to sell the 18th century clock, a left-handed scythe, the hand-operated forklift, a wartime garden trolley, and the lawn sweeper.
So, would you say you're quite excited about this, then?
Yes, in a way, in a kind of a mild, controlled manner.
Is there one piece that you think I want that thing to do well?
The clock.
The clock?
Yes.
The sale's about to begin, and we just have time to hear what today's auctioneer, Matthew Caddick, makes of Anthony's lots. Take 110 there
now. Well, Anthony's presented us with a real range of items, from the very collectible and valuable in terms of the bracket clock, to the more quirky and functional in terms of the farming and the agricultural items, and the more functional forklifts and so on. So let's see what happens. It's a quirky one, but who knows?
Let's hope there's at least one left-handed gardener in the gathering of potential buyers, as the scythe is about to go under the hammer.
Start me £10 for this. Good decorative lot, £10 for it. 10 there, 12's here, 15. 18's my last, would you like 20? You'll win at £20, take two now. He's got it at £20, are we done and selling? 194, £20.
Is that all right?
Yeah, that's okay.
Happy with that?
Mm-hmm.
And we're bringing in the sheaves with a very respectable £20. Next up is the wartime garden trolley with an estimated value of £150 to £300. Anthony's put on a reasonable reserve price of £100.
And is there £100 for it? £100 in the room for it? Let's start at 50 and we'll see where it goes. £50 bid me. No bids of £50. Shall I pass this lot? No interest at 50 then. Not sold.
Sadly, the garden trolley doesn't sell, nor does the lawn sweeper or the forklift.
Where's it going now?
Where's it going? I have to go back into store. Oh.
It appears Anthony's old hoarding habits are resurfacing. Last up is the 18th century clock, and it better chime on time, because with only £20 in the pot, Anthony's on a losing streak.
I've got two bids and I'm starting me at £500. I'll take 50 in the room. At £500, let me take 50 now. 550, 650, 750.
Yeah, that's better.
800 here with me, 850. At £800, all done, and selling at 800.
Good. Excellent.
You happy?
Yes.
lovely, doesn't it?
That makes up the other one.
800 is healthy.
The 18th century timepiece has saved the day, clocking in at £800, a timely salvation.
So, how do you think it went today, then?
I think it went very well. Yes, I mean, five items only, and of those, three didn't sell.
I know.
So, apart
two
from that...
Two sold,
and I'm very happy they got their, you know, minimum and maximum prices.
Yes.
The other three items, well, they'll live to fight another day.
With the success of Anthony's final lot, he's made today at auction £754.40 after commission. He's also managed to downsize one crate, making a yearly storage saving of £572. That's a grand total of £1,326.40. Add to that the amazing £18,000 offer for his train nameplate, and Anthony could be travelling first class all the way to the bank.
You've still got your storage unit, haven't you?
Yes.
You're still a storage user, aren't you?
Yes.
Are you going to change that at all in any way?
If my life changes, yes.
How would your life change?
Well, win the pools, buy a house, live with a woman again. All these things could happen.
That's right.
The older things... I get, going in a downhill slope, of course.
All these things could happen. How much are you spending on storage still?
Let's say less than £300 a month.
For better or for worse, Anthony's hoarding habit continues. But at least I've set him on the right track. Coming up, our expert Gillian delivers some hard truths.
Hopefully you'll get £2-3 a stem for it.
And Françoise bids a final farewell to her past.
5, 90, 5, 100, 110, 120.
Welcome back to Storage Hoarders, where I've been asking our two hoarders in denial to face their demons and downsize their units. Earlier, passionate hoarder Anthony made over £750 selling off unwanted items from his storage unit.
Good. Excellent.
As well as downsizing one crate and making a yearly storage saving of £572. Now the limelight turns on 70s pin-up and actress Françoise. She spent a total of £1,265 on storage over 8 months. Rummaging through the past has been emotional.
There's a lot of memories in two boxes.
But now she's ready to shed the items that she shared with her partner Simon for a better, brighter future. I've called on antiques expert Gillian Anderson Price to see if she can identify any of Françoise's unwanted items to sell at auction.
Well, obviously, it's general household accumulation that you kind of didn't want to deal with and thought, well, I'll just put it away. But there's a few Royal Crown Derby ornaments, which I think people are probably still collecting, but a good maker's mark, good condition, again, at least, you know, a few pounds for it. I don't mean two or three, but hopefully, you know, no. Fives and tens.
That's good news that Françoise's Royal Crown Derby collectibles have value, but what about the glassware?
There's also loads of this glassware. None of it is signed, but there's a lot of it. So hopefully you'll get £2-3 a stem for it, which will all mount up. Mm. It'll definitely do okay at auction.
Film fan Françoise's massive DVD collection has also caught Gillian's eye.
I've never seen quite so many DVDs all in one place, other than, I don't know, maybe a supermarket or a DVD store. How do you amass this kind of volume of DVDs?
I think it's because we always waited, my late partner and I always waited for the film, you know, the DVD to come out of a new film. And I used to go and buy them and said, let's sit down and watch it. So I would buy two or three of them.
Well, so you've had your money's worth out of them.
Yeah.
So I think those may as well all be sold. You know, I'm sure there are people that buy massive quantities of DVDs, the same way there are people that buy massive quantities of CDs. Even if you get, I don't know, 10p each for them.
Yeah.
What do you think about what Gillian's just said to you?
It's encouraging.
Yeah?
It's encouraging, yeah. I always thought that they were rubbish, so what Gillian said, you know, it's very encouraging for me to see that, you know, something is coming out of it.
Yes.
You know, there's a lot of plates, there's a lot of glass, mm-hmm. You know, so... While it's not going to make a ton of money, when you add it all together, at least somebody else will get the benefit
exactly.
of it. You'll get the benefit of a few pounds, plus not having to pay for the storage anymore.
No,
so
exactly.
I think it's worth sending as much to auction as possible and just disposing of it.
With the memory of late partner Simon locked in her heart, Françoise has unlocked some value in at least some of the remnants of her past. Among the pieces she'll be taking to auction are the mixed glassware and crystal, the Royal Crown Derby collectibles, a selection of domestic crockery, and with celebrity autographs at an all-time high, Françoise has decided to put her whole collection up for auction. It's auction time again, and Françoise is ready to put history under the hammer. No reserves, no reservations.
So you look really excited about this.
Yeah, I am.
And you don't feel at all sad about letting your stuff go?
No, I've come to terms with it. I really have come to terms with everything now.
How do you think that's happened then?
I think since the first day that we went into the storage, I suddenly realised afterwards that I have to let go of the past and I have to let go of everything that I have because I want them to go. I want to start a new life. I want to start again.
I'm keen to get the lowdown on what today's auctioneer Matthew Caddick makes of Françoise's stash.
Glassware in particular is one where it's an interesting mix. There's acid-etched examples, there's Bristol blue. All of these things are fairly collectible, even now. And it's got a very tame estimate. I would expect that they would get probably closer to the £100 on the day, but we'll have to see what happens. I think there's a lot there for the money. Of the framed items that we were presented with, the BBC Goon Show ephemera, the printed photographs with signatures, is an interesting item. It would have been far more interesting had it had the third signature. So one has to be a little bit realistic, and I would expect that you're much lower down the spectrum in the ones, maybe 150 mark. But again, let's see what happens.
In terms of today, what do you think is going to be your earner here?
Maybe the goons.
The goons, you think the goon, you got your money on the goons?
Yeah, I got my money on the goon.
Giving you money.
Yeah.
Have you got an idea in your head about how much you might get for that?
Oh, I would say about 100.
Yeah.
Well, here's hoping, and first to go under the hammer is the Goons print signed by legends Spike Milligan and Harry Secombe. The autograph expert valued it at £70 to £100.
Stop me £100 for this. Stop me £50. Interesting item at £50, bid me. No one likes it at £50, they'll ask 30. No interest at £30. 10 unbid there, 12, 15, 18, 20, 22, thank you, 25, 28. At £25, 183.
Yeah. You win some, you lose some.
Disappointed, but that's okay.
£25.
But that's okay.
Okay, good for you, good for you.
Sold for £25, well under the estimate. There were obviously no Goons fans at auction today. Françoise's three other film prints make a total of £55. Let's hope her lady killers makes a killing.
We've got two people who have seen them this morning and bid. I'm starting me at £100, I'll take £110 in the room. £100 and me take £110 now. At £100, are we all done? Nice round money and selling at £100 and gone then.
£100?
Wow.
Yeah, fantastic.
That's more like it, and another £100 in the kitty. The various ceramic collectibles also pull in a healthy £155. Last up is Françoise's mixed glassware. Let's hope there's a thirsty buyer out there.
I've been already at £25, I'll take 28 in the room. 28 there, 30, 32. You've beaten the commissioner at £32, 35 there, 38, and 40, 42, 45, 48, and 50, and 5, 60, and 5, 70, and 5, 80, 70, 80 there, 85, 90, 5, 100, 110, 120. Are we done and out at £110?
I take it you're quite happy with that.
What a turn up for the books. The mixed glassware is the toast of the town, cashing in at £110.
Six items, all went. Good prices. How are you feeling?
Fantastic. Really very, very, very good. I had such a good day. And it's an experience I will always remember.
So, and I hear that you've done something with the DVDs. You saw some.
Yes,
DVDs?
I saw the DVDs, and they were
actually. How much did you get for those?
They were £105 to £108.
So, is there anything else that you've sold on your own?
Yes, I have. I sold some of my clothes at boot sales.
Really?
For £150, which was absolutely super.
You've really got the bug, haven't you?
Yes.
With Françoise's success at auction today, the pounds have been adding up. After commission, she's made £409.40 at auction. She also took Gillian's advice and sold her DVD collection for £105 and her clothes for a further £150. Slap onto this an annual storage saving of £864 and Françoise's grand total is £1,528.40.
So you're going to be roving in money now. What are you going to do with it all?
Well, you know, I think most of them will be swallowed up by bills.
But you freed up £159 a month.
Yes.
Isn't that fantastic?
That's brilliant.
That is such a chunk of money.
It is.
And so do you think your storage days are over?
Yes. I've learned not to hoard anymore. And I won't.
Françoise came to me with a heavy heart. Now she's clearly put the past behind her and she's free to face her future without the baggage that slowed her down.
So there we have it. Françoise is free of storage stress, but Anthony will have to remain a statistic in the increasing number of British hoarders, though he is moving in the right direction. Join me, Aggie McKenzie, next time on Storage Hoarders.
Click on screen for more videos of extraordinary humans.